vital statistics, though, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Hi. I had a few questions. And they're a little bit sort of legal questions for birth certificates. Would you be the one to answer that?
Sure.
Okay. Now, although I have a birth certificate.
Okay.
Who actually owns this birth certificate?
It is owned by the government, and if you turn the birth certificate at the back, you're gonna see that it is a property of the government of Ontario.
Okay. That's what I wanted to know. Thank you. And so essentially, I'm carrying around this birth certificate because I know on your website it says not to use this for identification purposes.
Yes.
Would that be correct?
Yes.
Now, how does that work? What do you mean? What does that mean? Like, if you could, like...
Okay, a birth certificate is a proof of citizenship. It's not a proof of identity.
Okay, so would all these people who are running around getting driver's licenses and passports with the birth certificate, would those be illegal then?
No. As I mentioned, a birth certificate is a proof of citizenship. A driver's license is a proof of identity. It has your picture and it has a signature. A birth certificate doesn't have a photo on it. It is a proof of citizenship. It shows that you are born in this specific country.
Okay, and that's the only function that the birth certificate does for you?
Basically, yes. It is showing that what is your citizenship, and it determines where you are born. It is a difference, for example, for you who are born here and another person who are born in another country.
Right. So, essentially, it's just a way to show where you're born, obviously, because it's a birth certificate, but it's not my property. I don't own it.
No, you don't own it. That's why it said with all type of ID as well. You see that at the back because it is issued by the government, so it belongs to the government.
Right, and that's why it says they can request it back at any time.
Yes.
So they own everything in the birth certificate, and I just carried around to show that I was born in Canada.
Yes, and you are a Canadian citizen.
Okay. Now, essentially, is that why they hold the original and we only carry a copy?
No, you are not carrying a copy. If you do ask for your birth certificate, we're going to issue you the birth certificate that you want.
Yeah, but it says copy on it.
Yes, because we just give you a copy. Because what happened when you were born, somebody did the registration, and we based on that registration that we received that information to provide you a copy, which is a document that we call a birth certificate.
Okay. And so okay. The main question I really had though was who owns it. So.
Well, I think that I did respond to that.
Yeah,
question.
Yeah, and so the province owns it, right? So I was born in Ontario. So, like, what agency or who exactly owns it in Ontario? I mean, I know you said the province, but is there like a office or somebody I could contact about it?
No, it is owned by the government of Ontario in general. It's not by a specific person. No, it is owned by a government because the government is a government, which is a legal institution that provides all the type of document that you might need.
Right.
So it is the same as if you had a driver license. It is owned by the government of Ontario.
Right. So anything having to do with that name in the birth certificate goes to the government.
Yes. For example, you lose your birth certificate, whoever did find it gonna have to contact the government to advise the government that I did find a birth certificate, and they're gonna send it to us because they know that it belonged to us.
And where would they send that?
For example, today, if your birth certificate was stolen, whoever, for example, if you go to the police, they're going to tell you to report it to the government. They are basically telling you, whoever did give you that paper, you need to notify them. And they're going to take the appropriate action to make sure that your identity is preserved.
Okay, and let's say I found a birth certificate from Ontario. Where would I send it? What address?
Okay, we have an address, which is 189.
Right.
Red River Road, Thunderbird, Ontario. It is the office of the Register General.
Hold on, you said Right Rainbow Road?
No, Red, R-E-D.
Oh, okay.
River.
River, okay.
Yeah, road.
Right.
PO box 4600. You just make sure to put it in an envelope and mail it to that address.
And who is, what is this office again? What's this office called?
It is of the office of the Register General.
Is there any particular anybody in particular in that office that needs to get it?
No, because
Like
it is
a attention to director or you
as it is a birth certificate, you just can put attention birth certificate unit.
Okay.
Because we have many units here, we deal with anything related to birth certificate, death certificate, or marriage certificate. So if you are more precise in your information, it will just allow us to process the application.
Okay. So what I'm getting there is anything having to do with the ownership of the birth certificate has to go there. So anything that if someone's claiming to if someone's claiming ownership of this birth certificate, we direct them to you.
Because basically, if someone is even claiming the ownership of birth certificate, you just need to advise them that to read at the back of the certificate. That's why we made it clear that it belonged to the government.
Okay.
It'll
So
prove all. Yes.
if someone's say someone, because on a birth certificate it has a name on there, you know, say like John Henry, but all that information's ownership of the government. So if John Henry, and someone like Visa says John Henry owes Visa, you know, $5,000, we just send the bill over to you guys.
In that sense, it's like the same as I mentioned, if you find a birth certificate. So
Well, no,
it's it.
what I'm saying is if the visa bill is sent in the name of the birth certificate, then we send it to you guys, so you guys take care of it, you pay for it.
No, we don't pay for anything.
Why not? It's yours, you own it.
Yes.
If I drove, let me ask you this, if I drove your car and I got a red light ticket, ticket's not going to go to me, it's going to go to your house, right?
Back to what we did, how we did get that type of information. As I was mentioning earlier, before we are able to issue any type of birth certificate, the registration need to be done. So, for example, let's say you are mentioning John. When John was born, John's parents did send us some information to do the registration. So basically, in regard to your question, is just you are telling me, oh, okay, you are driving a car, but before you drive a car, you let the government know that, okay, I'm planning to buy a car, so here is the money.
Yeah, but we didn't. We no one paid anything in the in the hospital.
No, but they are doing the registration. They are at the, what they did, they just took the information and sent it to the government and let them know that at this specific date, this specific location, John was born, and here is a physician who did attend it, the birth. Because somebody came to us first and let know the government about the birth. It's not the way around.
Okay. Well, I'm just trying to clear that up so I know, 'cause essentially whoever owns something is usually one who takes care of any liability with that ownership, right?
That's why we, how we do it, take care of it. If, for example, the birth certificate is lost, they advise us and we deactivate that birth certificate. Nobody can deactivate his own or her own birth certificate. The government has to deactivate it.
So what is that? What happens when it gets deactivated?
It is, nobody can use it.
What do you mean? How does that happen?
For example, if for example, you lose your birth certificate and you contact the government to advise that I lost my birth certificate. Because you know that there are a lot of people around who might use it for type of bad activity or to use it for fraud. So if you let the government know, we're going to deactivate that birth certificate to make sure that nobody else will be able to use it.
Okay. Now, what if you're not what if you're not a citizen of this country? Because say for instance you're born in a nation like the Cayuga Nation or the Iroquois Nation of the Aboriginal people here.
Okay.
We aren't citizens of Canada. We actually are the original people of the land before Canada was even you know thought of.
Okay.
So how does that work?
What do you mean by how?
Well, if we are here first, before Canada was even made,
Yes.
and if we're already people who live here and we don't like essentially need birth certificates, or we're citizens of our own nation, people Mohawk or Cree or whatever nation they're
Yes.
from, how can Canada claim us as citizens if we are citizens of our own nation?
But you know that, like, some treaty has been signed long ago, so everything is based on the treaty that has been signed. So in regard to the treaty, I don't have much information about it, but I would just advise in that case, for example, if you belong to, if you are living in a reserve, for example, like the Six Nation, you can just talk to the chief and they will be able to advise you.
No, they couldn't. That's why I'm asking you guys.
No, because they are more in a position, because I cannot, in regard to who is a native or who is not a native, talk on their behalf, because I don't know that type of information. So if, for example, the chief are not able to advise you, I'm pretty sure that they might direct you in regard to the treaty that are in place to tell you exactly where you need to go.
Now, would you be able to dig up the information about what treaty you're referring to?
That's why I told you that to contact the treaty, to contact the chief,
Well,
they will be able.
he doesn't know.
No, I'm pretty sure that they know,
Because the
because what.
only treaty they're aware of is a treaty of a treaty called the Two World Wampum Belt.
Okay.
When the Two World Wampum Belt was made, the Queen, Her Majesty, the royalty over in England, had said that they will keep all their laws and
Okay.
all their religions and
Okay.
everything having to do with them, the Europeans,
Okay.
in their own boat,
Okay.
in their own boat. They keep it to themselves, and that the people of the Six Nations or the Iroquois, we keep everything in our canoe.
Yes, no, I totally understand. In that case as well, if, for example, your chief is unable to provide you with that information,
No,
as you have.
I'm telling you what was provided. This is what the treaty and it the treaty st the treaty stands in place even from when it was made long ago. So that's why I'm asking, how come the Queen or her officers are now pulling people out of our canoe into your boat and saying that now we're citizens of Canada?
Okay, so in that regard, you can just contact the Office of the Indian Affairs.
Do you have their number?
Okay, I can just try to find it for you. Anything related to that, you just need to contact them and they will be able to advise you.
Now, would there be anybody in your office who could advise me, who would know more than you, who would be higher than you?
No, there is no one, because in anything related to Indian Affairs, that's why they have a specific document which deal with that type of issue.
Okay, so I'll call them then.
Okay, no problem.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
You've been very, really helpful today.
Straight pulling up through the drive-thru so I can get my caffeine.
Hi, can I take your order, please?
So I can feel alive, the only way I could survive working this 9 to 5.